Welcome to SIR Learning Center. In previous lecture, we discussed the A-stable multivibrator. Now we are going to discuss the monostable multivibrator. How? In this lecture, we are going to discuss how to design monostable multivibrator by using the operational amplifier. In monostable multivibrator, one state is a stable state, and wherever you are applying the trigger signal, the output goes to the unstable state in a particular time duration. After the time duration, this unstable state comes to the stable state. That's why this monostable multivibrator has a one stable state and one unstable state. This unstable state time duration can be depends upon the passive components of R and C. This monostable multivibrator is commonly used in this timer circuit. Now we are going to see the monostable multivibrator. Before that, we know the A-stable multivibrator. In last lecture, we seen the A-stable multivibrator. We also known the design of A-stable multivibrator. Now, in this monostable multivibrator, slightly modified the A-stable multivibrator circuit, it converts the monostable multivibrator. The difference is, the one diode is connected across the capacitor and one input voltage applied in this node A. This circuit is called as the monostable multivibrator. How we are going to apply the trigger signal? By using the RC differential circuit. Here we are going to apply one pulse signal in the RC differential circuit. It can produce two spike signal. One is a positive spike signal, another one is a negative spike signal. It has the two edges. One is a rising edge, another one is a falling edge. In this monostable multivibrator, we are going to apply the trigger signal applied at the node A by using the RC differential amplifier. We are going to apply the negative trigger on the input of the differential circuit. It can produce the two spike signal. The two spike signal can be applied to the diode D2. This diode is in a reverse bias, that's why it only allow the negative half spike signal. This negative half spike signal is applied to the non-inverting terminal of the operational amplifier. Now we are going to explain the working principle of the monostable multivibrator. Initially, output becomes positive V saturation. Initially, the output becomes positive V saturation. It is a stable state. That time, the output at the node A is equal to R2 divided by R1 plus R2 into V saturation. This is the positive V saturation. It can be rewrite as beta into V saturation, that is the plus beta into V saturation. This beta is the feedback fraction. It is can be written as beta is equal to R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Whenever the positive saturation voltage, the diode D1 becomes forward bias. Here we are using the PN junction diode, the VD value is equal to 0.7 volt. It can only allow the 0.7 volt. That time, the voltage across the capacitor is equal to the forward voltage drop across the diode. This beta V saturation value is more than voltage at the inverting node. Output of the op-amp remain in the positive saturation voltage. After some time, the trigger pulse, this trigger pulse is applied at the node A. That time, voltage at not inverting terminal voltage is less than the inverting node. This voltage becomes less than the inverting node. So, output of the operational amplifier comes from the minus V saturation. That is negative V saturation. That time the circuit becomes unstable state. At this time, the voltage at the node A is minus beta B saturation. That is, what is going to happen here? The diode D1 becomes reverse bias. The capacitor becomes charged towards minus V saturation value. And the capacitor charge just below the minus beta V saturation, the output of the op-amp is plus V saturation at this time. At this time, voltage at non-inverting node is slightly more than voltage at the inverting node. The capacitor becomes start charging till VD value. Now we are going to design the monostable multivibrator. The equation of the monostable multivibrator is T is equal to RC into ln of 1 plus R2 divided by R1. Now we are going to consider T is equal to 10 millisecond and R1 is equal to R2 is equal to, here we are going to take, this is the value of 10 kilo ohm. Here T is equal to RC into ln of 1 plus 1. Because of R2 is equal to R1, that's why that value becomes 1 here. Now the RC into ln of 2. That value is T is equal to 0.693 into RC. Now we are going to consider C is equal to, assume C is equal to 1 microfarad. Now substitute this value to here, we are going to find the R value because of T value is already known, that is 10 millisecond. The R is approximately equal to 14.4 kilo ohm. This value can be getting by using the variable resistance in the feedback path. Next, we are going to calculate the value of T from the monostable multivibrator. The diode voltage denoted as VD. Now we are going to find the value of T here. The value of T is directly proportional to the resistor and capacitor. How we are going to find this value? The voltage drop across the capacitor, VC of T is equal to V final plus V initial minus V final into e power minus t by RC. Here V final is equal to minus V saturation. Why is minus V saturation? The capacitor discharge towards the minus V saturation value, negative saturation voltage. Then what is the initial value here? The initial value of the capacitor is VD because of the diode can be connected across the capacitor. Then the VC of T value is equal to minus V saturation plus VD plus V saturation into e power T divided by RC. At the end of time, T is equal to capital T and voltage across the capacitor VC of T is equal to B minus beta into V saturation because of this capacitor charge till minus beta V saturation value. That's why VC of T is equal to minus beta V saturation is equal to minus V saturation plus VD into, VD plus V saturation into e power minus t divided by RC. From this equation we are going to take V saturation is taken as a common outside. minus V saturation or plus V saturation. Here we are going to take the minus V saturation is taken as a common outside. What is going to happen here? This equation becomes 1 minus of 1 plus VD divided by V saturation into e power minus t by RC. This t value becomes capital because of the t is considered as a t, capital T. From this equation, we are going to consult beta V saturation value, V saturation value, and this minus. Finally, the answer is becomes beta is equal to 1 minus 1 plus VD divided by V saturation into e power minus t divided by RC. Now we are going to solve this equation where this term is come here, 1 plus VD divided by V saturation into e power minus t divided by RC is equal to 1 minus beta. Now we are going to find e power minus t divided by RC is equal to 1 minus beta whole divided by 1 plus VD divided by V saturation. Now we are going to take the natural logarithm on both sides, that's why this term becomes cancel minus t. No, now we are going to write this once again. We are going to write e power t by RC is equal to 1 plus VD divided by V saturation. How we are going to take this equation? This term can be converted into positive, that's why we are going to take the reciprocal of this equation. 1 plus VD divided by V saturation, 1 minus beta. Now we are going to take the natural logarithm on both sides. That time what is going to happen? T by RC is equal to ln of 1 plus VD divided by V saturation whole divided by 1 minus beta. Now T is equal to RC into ln of 1 plus VD divided by V saturation in divided by 1 minus beta. The equations becomes T is equal to RC into ln of 1 plus VD divided by V saturation whole divided by 1 minus beta. Here this V saturation value is very very greater than the VD value. This VD value becomes 0.71. We are using the silicon type PN junction diode, and R1 is equal to R2. Already we know that beta is equal to R2 divided by R1 plus R2. That's why the beta value is equal to 0.5. Now we are going to consider V sat is greater than VD value, that in T is equal to RC ln of 1 divided by 1 minus beta. This equation can be rewrite with the help of R2 divided by R1 plus R2, RC ln of, now we are going to substitute beta value here, that the equation can be converted into 1 plus R2 divided by R1. Next, we are going to equate this R1 is equal to R2 here. That's why this value is becomes RC ln of 2. The natural logarithm of 2 is equal to 0.693 into RC. Then the T value is equal to 0.693 into RC. What's the meaning of that one? The time duration of the pulse signal is directly proportional to the resistance and capacitance of the monostable multivibrator. And we are going to find the F of this equation. F is equal to 1 divided by, in this monostable multivibrator, the trigger pulse should be less than the pulse with T. This is the monostable multivibrator. Thank you.